Welcome to episode 15 of the Miss Strawberry Makes podcast. I'm Michelle. This is a crafty podcast about crocheting, knitting, sewing, and any other crafty shenanigans that I get up to. You can find me on Instagram as Miss Strawberry Short Girl, on Ravelry as Miss Michelle Bell. We have a Ravelry group for this podcast called The Strawberry Patch. Come and join. And you can find the show notes for this podcast on my blog, missstrawberrymakes.blogspot.com. Link below. Last time, which was like over 3 weeks ago, I think, I didn't end up getting the show notes written up, but nobody seemed to miss them. If there was something in the last episode that you needed to know about, just contact me, and I will let you know whatever that was. So, well, I hope you all have been well since we last had a little crafty talk. I've been well. We've been having a lovely summer. Some quite hot days, but that's okay. It is summer after all. We went to the carnival, as I think I ended with that last week, that we're hoping to go to the carnival, and we did. It stayed clear long enough for us to ride all the rides, and I did ride some rides, and it was fun. So, yep, the wee rabbits enjoyed it too. Let's see, this week, I don't think I have any interesting news apart from I do have one exciting thing to share with you all, and it is, the clue is in what I'm wearing today. It has to do with Beatrix Potter. It is a Beatrix Potter swap that two Instagram friends and I are putting on. So, and we just posted about it today. Today is Thursday, July 19th, and it will run through Saturday, July 28th, which is Beatrix's birthday. So, in honor of her birthday, we are having a crafty Beatrix Potter swap. So, the two friends who I'm doing this with is Jackie of, I'll put her Instagram handle down here. It's Via Joy Boupri or something like that. Do you ever just, like, not actually read people's names when it's not like a name that you actually know, you just like can picture it in your head but you don't necessarily ever say it out loud? So anyway, Jackie and Kristen of Bobby Pin Bandit, two Beatrix Potter loving gals. So we have teamed up to host a swap. For we are limiting it to 80 participants, so you'll want to get in and join ASAP so that you get a spot. And for all the details, there is a link in all of our Instagram profiles that leads to a Google sign-up for this swap. And you will need to make one handmade item, Beatrix Potter-themed, at least one handmade item, and then two other items that may be store-bought if you wish, or they can also be crafty. Or something vintage, but just anything Beatrix Potter goes. So, there's that, and it needs to fit in like a 9x12 envelope. I think we stipulated that as well, just so that it doesn't end up being too expensive to ship for anyone. And everyone gets roughly the same size swap that way. And the parcels will need to be mailed by September 1st of this year. So, you'll have about a month to a little over a month to work on all your projects. So, all the information for that, like I said, is on our Instagrams and on the link in our Instagram bios. So, okay, I'm really excited about that. It's going to be so much fun. So, I'm just going to bop right into finished objects, because what I have to show you is actually somewhat to do with that. So how this started was Jackie and I were doing a Beatrix Potter swap of our own. And just for fun, just the two of us. And so I have a couple things that I have made for her. So Jackie, if you're watching this, look away now. Because I'm going to show what I've made you so far, even though I have shared some pictures on Instagram, so you probably have a bit of an idea anyway. Anyway, so we were having our own little Beatrix Potter swap, and then Jackie had the idea to host it as one for like that everyone can, well, at least 80 people can enjoy. So, and she invited along Kristen, who's also a Beatrix Potter fan, and Kristen, like, has put so much work into this already, so thankful for her. Okay, well, hopefully Jackie's not looking, but I made this Beatrix Potter tote bag out of the fabric that my friend Donna sent me. Well, some of the fabric. I still have quite a bit of it left. I did some leftover denim I had on the bottom. It looks black in some pictures, but it's not. It's just really dark navy. Hopefully you can see that. And then to bring out the pink in here, I added pink rickrack, some natural colored webbing for the straps. This fabric ruffle on the top has little gardening kids on it. I think it's just so cute. And then the lining fabric has fruit on it, 'cause I didn't have any veggie fabric, but I thought, you know, gardeny themed. And then there's my little label in there. And then I popped on one of the strawberry scissor keepers. By Sandra Paul. Sandra, I should say. I always say it American Sandra, but it's Sandra. Sounds so much lovelier, don't you think? And I also made her this little zippered pouch out of some leftover yarn from my Beatrix Potter Cardi, my Granny Cardi, and Beatrix Potter Colors. And I lined it with some of the leftover fabric from this dress. The skirt of this dress. So I think that's sweet. Stripey back and a little Peter knitted into the front. I really love this. It's so sweet. I want to make up another one of them. So that is my first finished object. Objects, I guess, because it's two. So, and then, okay. My next finished object is my Rainbow Bright socks. I made these for the Rainbow Along put on by Jules of So Sweet Violet and Amy of The Little Tailoress. So they are finished. Still don't have sock blockers, but I'm happy with how they turned out. I've worn them a couple times, so they're a little bit fuzzy already. I tried really hard to match them up, and they match exactly except for this has like one more row of blue ribbing, but that's okay. You can barely tell. So, yep, really happy with those, and it was my first afterthought heel. So, and my first swirl toe, actually, also. Still really happy with those. And yeah, can't think of much else to say. Anything else I had to say about them, I've said previously when they were a work in progress. So, the yarn was Knit Picks Felici and Candy Shop. Such a pretty colorway. So, really happy with those. Okay, and then my last finished object is my Honeydew top. I don't think I even talked about this yet last time. I think it was done before it even saw a podcast. But this is. Oh, let me grab the book real quick. Okay, this is from Knit Simple, Soft and Simple Tops to Knit. And I got this book for the price of one digital download on abebooks.com. Abe as in Abraham Lincoln, books.com. So they sell used books for really reasonable. And it is the first pattern in here. Pleat neck top. So, and I made it from Debbie Bliss Amalfi yarn. I think this was called Lime, maybe, but it makes me think of honeydew melon, so I called it my honeydew top. I've worn it a couple times, so it's a little not as nicely shaped as it had been right after blocking, but it fits really nicely. I really like it. I shortened the overall length by about 2 inches in the body. I didn't shorten the arm part at all, and if I were to make it again, and I've said this on Instagram, I would shorten it by a few rows because the armholes are very large. They go down pretty low, but I just wear a tank top under it and it's fine. But yeah, so in the shaping, I did one row less in between each of the decreases and then also increases, one row less both ways. And so it ended up being about 2 inches shorter, 1 inch here, 1 inch here. And it fits really nicely to suit my short stature. So I'm really happy with it, and it's so soft. I have some of this yarn left from another project in a really pretty pale blue color, but I don't think I have quite enough to make one of these. But I'm hoping maybe if I do shorten the top, maybe I will just have enough to do that. So that'd be really great. I might insert some pics here of me wearing it, even though they always turn out grainy, but just so you can see what it looks like on right here. Yep, so I'm really happy with how that turned out. Excuse me while I finish my tea real quick. It's getting a little cool. Well, I might still save just a little bit so I don't have to gulp it all down in front of you guys here. Okay, so that is all of my finished objects. Now, for works in progress, I have begun on my wee rabbit knitting for my new little nephews. I almost said grandsons. My new little nephews coming along very soon. This one is actually for my sister Beth's baby, who's due in October. Kelsey's baby is due the end of this month, so maybe I should have made that one first, but I wanted to make, but it's not like the baby can wear it until fall anyway, because this is woolly. It's, Debbie Bliss Baby Cash Merino in Mustard is the yarn. I had the label somewhere. Oh, here's Debbie Bliss Baby Cash. The best yarn ever. I'm sure you all know, but it's 55% wool, 33% acrylic, and 12% cashmere. And it's washable, which is wonderful for babies. But Bethy picked out this lovely mustard color for her little baby boy, which I don't know his name yet. I don't know either of the baby's names yet. Beth and her husband are still in deliberations, and Kelsey and her husband aren't telling because they're mean. But anyway, here it is so far. All I have left to do is the shawl collar and the button bands. I'm sort of winging this pattern, and the reason I wanted to do Beth's babies first is because it'll be smaller sized than Kelsey's baby because he'll be a couple months older. So I wanted to see if I needed to size up for it or just make the same size. And to make it fit down, cinched in nicely, I did cables because it's basically like a ribbed sweater. Then it like cinches in. See, you can see when it's pulled out. So it fits a wider range, I feel like. And it looks really nice. So, I'm doing a shawl-necked cardigan, I think I said that, and, I'm following a couple different patterns. The one pattern I'm following is shawl-necked jacket, I think, from, Debbie Bliss's Design It, Knit It Babies, but it was written for DK weight yarn, and this is sport weight, and, because I wanted it to be smaller. And also it didn't have cables. I added the cables. So I did follow how they have you pick up stitches for the sleeves. It's a drop shoulder cardigan. So like there's no armhole shaping here. It's just straight up. And then I actually knit the body of it in one with no side seams. And then I just stopped at where it would be time for the sleeve to start. I just stopped and carried on with just one front, then just the back, then just the other front. And then joined the shoulder seams and picked up stitches for the sleeves. And I had to do the sleeves twice because the first time I picked up way too many stitches and like it actually fit on my forearm comfortably. And it's for like 0 to 3 months, so that's, you know, way too big. But anyway, they are really looking good now, I think. I'm happy with that. Hopefully they aren't too small now, but I think they look proportionate to the sweater, which is what I was going for. So almost done with that. Really happy with it so far. The cables I'm doing are just every fifth row. Yeah. Every fifth row a cable, and where's it? Every sixth. Well, anyway, it's five plain rows, one cable row. Yeah, so sixth row, I guess. But I do, it's over six stitches, and so every other I do a front and a back over six stitches with three purls in between. So nicely spaced. And I really like how, I didn't even mean to, but under the arm it actually splits a cable right in half. I really like how that looked, and so then it's got this little ridge of plain stockinette right by the sleeve. I think that looks really nice, really handsome. So happy with that. And then my next work in progress is I'm making a unicorn blanket for my niece Annalise. She loves unicorns. And this will probably be for her birthday, which is in October, so I've got plenty of time. But inspiration had struck and I just needed to start working on it. But I've stopped now because I was working on that sweater, which needs to be done sooner probably. And then also I've started another ripple blanket, which I'll talk about in just a moment. But this is for my niece Annalise. Sandra Paul of Cherry Heart was saying she's making her niece a Essence of Unicorn blankie using her Getting Ziggy pattern, but modifying it to a blanket instead of a shawl. So anyway, I was thinking, well, my niece sure loves unicorns too. I'd like to make an Essence of Unicorn blanket, but this is my interpretation on what a unicorn is, with bearing Annalise in mind, because anytime she sees something pink, she says, that's pink, it's mine. Anything pink is hers. She is three, so she'll be four in October. So I used some, just a bunch of leftover pinks I had in stash. And I also added this, I don't know if it's showing up well, but this fuzzy, kind of shimmery white yarn too, which I think that's so fun to have a fuzzy ripple in there too. So I think Annalise will be very pleased with that. And I showed it to my niece Abby, who's 9, going on 10 in October also, and she loved it. And I was like, would you like a blanket like that too? And she's like, yes. And I told her it was supposed to be unicorn themed. She's like, well, it needs turquoise in it. Or I think she said blue, but she meant like aqua in it. If it's going to be unicorn, like, duh, that's like a unicorn color. You can't not have that. So in hers, I'll add in some minty or aqua or something like that. And her favorite color is purple, so I'll probably focus more on purples than pinks in hers. So there's that one. And then my other, I told you I had just started another ripple blanket, and it's going to be in these colors. And it's for a commission for my aunt, who is having her first grandbabies, and it's twins. So I'm actually making her two blankets, both the same. She found this idea on Facebook. Anyway, it starts out sand colored and it's a ripple blanket. So it goes from sand and then gradually joins in this color and then gradually it adds in another darker blue. And it's to look like the ocean, like the beach going into the ocean. And then you make little crochet, little appliques of sea turtles crawling out into the ocean. It's so cute, such a cute idea. And I'm really excited to make that one. So just started on that. Need to really focus on that because it's a closer deadline than that so that they'll be ready for the baby shower. But anyway, okay, what else do I have? Oh, another thing I was making for the rainbow along. Let me grab it. I forgot to pull it up. Is the other thing I'm making for Jules and Amy's rainbow along is pastel rainbow bunting. These all need blocked really badly, but they are leftovers from my I Love Summer scarf. And I did all the hearts in these little colors, and these are the leftovers from it. So I just need to block these, and then join them, and they will be a little pastel rainbow bunting for decoration in here. Won't that be so cute? So I'll probably join it with the white. But it's got all the colors, and I'll probably put it in rainbow order too. So it'll be pink for red, peach for orange, yellow, mint, blue, purple. Oh, actually there's two blues and two purples, so we'll add them in too, but probably in order of the rainbow. So that'll be really cute, don't you think? And the pattern I was using is Heather of Pink Milk's tutorial for crochet bunting, simple little triangles made out of single crochet. So there's that. That's on my Ravelry if you need any other details. Okay, well guys, I think that's all I have to share with you for today. Don't forget to go join the Beatrix Potter swap. It should be a lot of fun. We're really looking forward to that. And swaps are just so much fun to do, aren't they? So jump on to Instagram and join that. Yeah, so I always don't know how to stop a podcast. I'm just rambling now. Anyway, thanks for watching. I so appreciate it. If you're a new viewer, I forgot to say, hey, welcome. Thanks for watching. Usually I say that at the beginning, but I do appreciate each and every one of you who watches and comments and likes, and I thank you for joining me, and I look forward to chatting with you again real soon. Thanks for watching. Happy making! Bye.